was June 2017 when a gunman opened fire at a GOP baseball practice for the annual congressional baseball game, wounding five people and critically wounding our next guest, Louisiana Congressman Steve Scalise. 2 years later, he's preparing once again to take the field in tomorrow night's game. Welcome to our broadcast, Congressman.
Lauren, good to be back with you.
When we talked about this last year, you eloquently spoke about the miracles of that day. Doctors said you were in imminent risk of death. Can you tell our audience about how God intervened in your trip to the hospital that day and how you've grown in faith since then?
Yeah, you know, I mean, it was one of these unexpected things, but once I knew I was hit, I went down and I'm trying to crawl away from the gunfire, and my arms ultimately gave out after, I guess, about 20 feet of crawling, and I could still hear gunfire, and for all I knew, you know, the next shot could be it. And so I just started to pray, and it was just something that came into my head, and I have a faith, I have strong faith, but I wasn't somebody who shared it a lot with other people. And yet, once I did start praying, it was amazing how much of a sense of calm I got, even with the shootout that was still going on. I knew I'd put it in God's hands. I asked God for some very specific things, and He was there. He delivered everything I asked, and saved my life.
What did you ask for,
Congressman? That ball field.
Yeah, what did you ask for?
Help. You know, the first thing I asked for, and I know the first thing is stop the shooting.
No,
what came into my head first was I've got a daughter now. She's 12, but at the time was 10 years old. And I just had this image of Madison walking up the aisle alone, and I just said, God, please don't let my daughter walk up the aisle alone. And that was,
well, look, here
the
you
first
are.
Thing I thought of, and you know, got to make it through, and get to see my family again, and all that. So, you know, prayed for those kind of miracles, and they happened. And heroes, they were real heroes on that ball field too.
Yeah,
and,
you've been
I wrote a book about it called Back in the Game to really chronicle.
I think
for so many
to have
people that
right
to know
here
what
in
it
my
was
hand
like, to be able to see it.
I have it. Yeah, and it's a fabulous book. You have been very open about working through your Catholic faith to forgive the gunman. He died after police shot him. What has that journey been like?
Yeah, you know, that's something that I still talk with faith leaders that I've known and interact with a lot is, you know, kind of how do you forgive? And it's such an important part of my Catholic faith, but I've got to practice it now, and I'm working to get there. I'm not quite there yet, but I've talked to some really good people who've there was a pastor I was with the vice president a few months ago, and they had some churches that were burned down, some historically black churches that were burned in South Louisiana, and they ultimately caught the arsonist. And we went and toured one of the churches, and the pastor of that church shared with me that the first thing he did when they caught the arsonist was he forgave him.
Wow.
You know, and here's,
we're hard.
Walking through the ruins of his burned down church, and yet he already forgave. And I talked to him about it. I said, how did you get there? Because I'm not there. And he was familiar with my shooting. And we talked about it a lot. And, Reverend Tucson is somebody, one of those people that's helping me. And there are others too. And I appreciate it because I do want to get there.
Well, before we go, I do want to turn to politics and policy. You say that President Trump is right to continue applying maximum sanctions on Iran, and Democrats are pretty skeptical. Where do we go from here?
Well, where we need to go is to make sure that we don't have a nuclear-armed Iran. And I think you see the actions just a few weeks ago. You know, they blew up two tankers in the Strait of Hormuz. They're once again trying to be the bully in the Middle East, and that's without a nuclear weapon, but they're getting closer. They're saying they're going to violate the terms of the agreement that the bad deal that President Obama signed with Iran, where he ultimately, even if they complied with all the rules, they could get to where they're ready to develop it and build a nuclear weapon. And they're testing missiles to distribute it. I mean, this is dangerous. We don't want a nuclear-armed Iran. And President Trump's been very clear about that, too. And so he's taken actions and increased sanctions to push back on Iran. And you're seeing Iran act out again. And so we all need to stand up. Our allies, by the way, in the Middle East don't want a nuclear-armed Iran, starting with Israel.
Right. Okay. Well, it has been just Such a pleasure talking to you. Thank you so much for telling us your story, your faith journey. Congressman Steve Scalise, Republican from Louisiana.
Thanks. Great being with you.